Hello, dear students. Good morning to all of you. Today, I shall start a new chapter, first chapter from civics. Our constitution. In your previous classes, you studied about the Constitution of India. And I think that all of you know better that the Constitution of India is the largest constitution in the world. Indian Constitution contains 395 articles and 12 schedules. You will study in next chapter in detail. The Constitution of UK is not a written constitution, while US Constitution contains only 7 articles. Directive principles, fundamental rights, parliamentary form of government, all these things are taken from different nations. So let us start the Constitution of India. The Constitution of India came into effect on 26 January 1995, when India became a sovereign democratic republic. Constitution, what do you mean by the term Constitution? Constitution is a comprehensive document. Constitution is a comprehensive document containing the set of rules that describe the rights and duties of its citizens and the manner according to which the governments of a country is to be carried out. This is constitution. It is called constitution. It regulates the position. Constitution regulates the position and powers of the three organs of the government. Three organs of the government: the legislative, the executive, and the judiciary. And it states how they are interrelated. It assumes a special importance as it moderates relations with the government and the governed. Further, it protects the interests of the citizens by restraining the government from taking arbitrary decisions. The aim of a constitution of a nation is to ensure, underline this line, the aim of a constitution of a nation is to ensure a smooth governance for the welfare of its citizens, for the welfare of its citizens. The principles of the constitution distinguish a constitutional or democratic government from an absolute monarchy or a dictatorship. enactment of the Indian Constitution. Enactment means the process of passing legislation. Enactment of the Indian Constitution. We have studied in the Freedom Movement of India. In your previous class, you studied a chapter, the Freedom Movement of India. Okay. We have studied in the Freedom Movement of India that the cabinet mission, it came in 1946. That the cabinet mission arrived in India in 1946 and put forward a set of proposals to meet the demands of the freedom fighters. Okay. Means the cabinet mission put before the freedom fighters a set of proposals to meet the demands of the freedom fighters. One of these proposals involved setting up of a constituent assembly whose members were to be elected indirectly by the provincial legislative assemblies, lower house only. Elections to the provincial assembly were completed. Elections to the provincial assembly were completed by July 1946. The princely estates were represented by the members nominated by the rulers of these estates. The Constituent Assembly of Undivided India consisted of 389 members, 292 elected, 93 nominated by the princely estates, 3 from the chief commissioner provinces, and 1 from the British. The Constitution of India was framed by the Constituent Assembly. Means the Constitution of India was framed by the Constituent Assembly. Underline this portion also, an important topic. Formation of the Constituent Assembly. How the Constituent Assembly was formed. The first sitting of the Constituent Assembly was held on December 9, 1946. Means the first meeting of the Constituent Assembly was held on December 9, 1946. It was held at the present Central Hall of the Parliament and was presided over by Dr. Sachidanand Sinha, the oldest sitting member of the Central Assembly. On December 11, 1946, Dr. Rajendra Prasad was elected president of the Constituent Assembly. Means the first meeting was held. The first meeting was presided over by Dr. Sachidanand Sinha on 9 December, and on 11 December, Dr. Rajendra Prasad was elected president of the Constituent Assembly. The Muslim League boycotted the Constituent Assembly to demand the Muslim League. The Muslim League boycotted. Boycotted means refused to take part. The Muslim League boycotted the Constituent Assembly to demand the creation of a separate state called Pakistan. The main reason of the Muslim League not to take part in the meeting which was held by the Constituent Assembly because they were demanding for a separate state Pakistan. Consequently, the members representing the territories which went to Pakistan withdrew from the Constituent Assembly of India. As a result, the membership of the Constituent Assembly of India stood at 299 against the original number of 389 members. Of these, 284 were actually present on November 26, 1949, and appended means add something to the end of a written document, means a document was prepared and they put their signature. Okay, means 284 were actually present in the meeting which was held on 26 November 1946, and appended their signatures to the constitution as finally passed. Dr. Rajan Prasad continued to be the president of the Constituent Assembly of India. Between December 9, 1946 and August 14, 1947, the assembly held 5 sessions. Between December 9, 1946 to August 14, 1947, the assembly held 5 sessions. You have to keep in your mind, underline this point. The assembly held 5 sessions between December 9, 1946 and August 14, okay, 1947. The assembly held 5 sessions. Composition of the Constituent Assembly. How the Constituent Assembly was formed. The wide-ranging membership of the Constituent Assembly gave a representation to all sides of public opinion. The Cabinet Mission Plan had ensured a representation to only 3 categories. The Cabinet Mission Plan had ensured representation to only 3 categories: the general category, Muslims and Sikhs. The Congress leaders had, however, ensured that other communities like Anglo-Indians, Indian Christians, scheduled castes, and scheduled tribes got a representation. The Anglo-Indians were represented by Mr. Frank Anthon and Mr. S.H. Prater, the Indian Christians, by Dr. H.C. Mukherjee and Joseph D'Souza, and the Parsis by H.P. Modi, though the Muslim League had boycotted the assembly. They refused to take part in the meeting which was held for the formation of the Constitution of India. The Muslim League boycotted. There were still 2 members. In spite of this, 2 Muslim members, Jafar Imam and Muhammad Sadullah, who represented the Muslim community. The 6 were represented by Sardar Hukum Singh and Ujwal Singh. Sardar Hukum Singh and Ujwal Singh. It can be said that the Constituent Assembly was a truly national in character. What was the objectives of the resolution? When the Constituent Assembly started the work of drafting the Constitution of India, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru proposed the objective resolution. When the Constituent Assembly started the work of drafting the Constitution, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru proposed the objectives resolution on December 13, 1946. The resolution highlighted the objectives and laid down the national goals. The first objective was free India will be nothing but a republic. This was the first point. Second point, the ideals of social, political, economic democracy would be guaranteed to all people. The ideals of social, political, and economic democracy would be guaranteed to all people. Third point, the republic would grant fundamental rights to citizens. And the last point of this objective resolutions was the state would safeguard the rights of minorities and backward classes. The objective resolution was passed by the Constituent Assembly on January 22nd, 1947. After this, the drafting committee started working. The Indian Independence Act 1947, by which two independent states of India and Pakistan were created. The Indian Independence Act 1947 was passed. According to this act, India, British India, was divided into two parts. And the first part is known as India, and the second part is known as Pakistan. India and Pakistan were created, recognized the existence of the Constituent Assembly of India. This legal faction enabled the Constituent Assembly to function after India's independence. Okay, this legal section enabled the Constitution to function. The Assembly became a sovereign body to carry on its work. It appointed eight committees. Eight committees were appointed. The drafting committee, under the chairmanship of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, was set up on August 29, 1947, and was entrusted with the task of drafting the Constitution. Means the main task was given to Dr. B.R. Ambedkar for the drafting of the Constitution of India. Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar contribution to the Indian Constitution was great. Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar, popularly known as Baba Saheb, was one of the architect of the Constitution of India. B.R. Ambedkar was the architect of the Constitution of India. Underline this word, architect of the Constitution of India. Dr. Bhim Rao Ambedkar was one of the architects of the Constitution of India. He was an eminent jurist, economist, politician, and social reformer. The text of the Constitution prepared by Baba Saheb provided for constitutional guarantees and protections for a wide range of civil liberties for Indian citizens, including freedom of religion, the abolition of untouchability, social rights for women, and a system of reservation of jobs in the government services for members of scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. In order to shape India into a complete sovereign democratic republic in which the liberty and dignity of the individual is ensured along with national integrity, Baba Saheb incorporated the following principles in the Constitution. Baba Saheb, Dr. Bhim Rao Ambedkar incorporated a few principles, okay, and those principles ensured the individual liberty and dignity along with national integrity. First point, the first principle made the Indian Constitution workable, flexible, and is strong enough to hold the country together both in peace and in war. This was the first principle. Second principle, provided special safeguards to the minorities. Special safeguard to the minorities and certain classes who are socially and economically backward. Third, incorporated the right to the constitutional remedies to ensure that the fundamental rights of the individuals are not infringed by the center or the state government. Fourth principle, single citizenship, single judiciary, and uniformity in fundamental laws to integrate Indian society. Therefore, he proposed a strong center to maintain territorial integrity and administrative discipline. Center was made very strong to maintain administrative discipline and territorial integrity. Readings. The draft was discussed by the Constituent Assembly class by class since November 4, 1948. Thereafter, the draft underwent the second reading, which was completed on October 17, 1949. It was followed by the third and the final reading, which were completed on November 26, 1947. Time taken. It took nearly 3 years for the Constituent Assembly to finally pass the Constitution. At the time of its signing, the Constitution consisted of 395 articles and 8 schedules. I told you 12 schedules. Later it was increased. 8 schedules. Implementation of the Constitution. After the signing of the Constitution, only the clauses relating to the citizens and some others came into force immediately. This was to enable persons displaced as a result of partition to register themselves as Indian citizens. The constitution was adopted and passed by the Constituent Assembly on November 26, 1949. The constitution as a whole came into force with effect from January 26, 1945. It was adopted on November 26, 1949, and it came into force on 26 January 1950. With the coming into force of the Constitution, C. Rajagopalachari became the first Governor General of Independent India. Okay. He replaced Lord Mountbatten, the British Governor General. The Constituent Assembly became the provincial parliament until the new general elections were held in 1951 and 52. The general elections were held in 1951 and 52. Dr. Rajendra Prasad, who was the president of the Constituent Assembly, took over as the president of Indian Union. Significance of 26th January. Every year, all of you, the whole country, celebrate 26th January as a Republic Day. And what is the significance of 26th January? The date January 26, 1950 for the commencement of the Constitution was especially selected because of its historical importance. At the Lahore session of the Congress held in December 1929, a resolution was passed which declared Purna Swaraj, our complete independence, to be the objective of the Congress. January 26, 1930 was fixed as the first Independence Day, which was to be so celebrated every year. Since then, the day was celebrated as Independence Day up to 1947. On achieving independence, when India became free, 15th August 1947 became the Independence Day, and January 26 was designated as the Republic Day. Here some fact files are given here. Point number one. Point number one is given, the Constituent Assembly elected July 1946, first session December 9, 1946, objective resolutions proposed December 13, 1946 by Jawaharlal Nehru, objective resolution passed January 22nd, 1947. Drafting committee set up August 29, 1947. First draft completed February 1948. Second reading October 1949. Third reading November 1949. Constitution passed and adopted November 26, 1949. Constituent Assembly members, undivided India, India by itself, undivided India, 389. India by itself, 1799. Okay. At the time of commencement, Articles 395, Schedules 8. So this is the Constitution of India in a nutshell. And you have to keep in your mind the objective resolutions, fact files, and C. Rajagopalachari was the first and last Governor General of independent India. Okay, C. Rajagopalachari was the first and the last Governor General of India. After C. Rajagopalachari, this post was not in existence. Okay. So now you can ask your doubts. Aradhya Pathak.
Hello, sir. Good morning.
Your voice is not clear. Aradhya Pathak. Hello.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Sir, what is the meaning of eminent jurist?
Eminent
sir, jurist. Meaning of eminent jurist.
Eminent means famous. Jurist means in a committee, some members are appointed as a jurist who are giving their decisions. Okay. They are jurist, and Bhim Rao Ambedkar was one of them.
Okay, sir.
Eminent means famous, well-known, illustrious. Jurist, he was economist, politician, and a social reformer. Now let down your hand.
Sir, one more doubt. Sir, meaning of infringed.
Infringed. Single citizenship, single judiciary, and uniformity in fundamental laws to integrate. Incorporated to.
Sir, third point.
Yes. Incorporated the right to constitutional remedies to ensure that fundamental rights of the individuals are not infringed by the center. Infringed means curtailed, diminished, seized. It is not in the power of the central government that central government will curtail or shorten or infringed the fundamental rights of the individual. Okay.
Okay.
Next one. Aradhya Pathak, let down your hand. Next one. Dhruva Srivastava.
Hello. Good morning, sir.
Very good morning.
Sir, can you explain objective resolution?
I was disconnected.
Sir, I was disconnected. Network problem.
Which one?
Sir, objective resolution on page number 123.
I think that you joined a little late. You are telling a lie. I see all of you when you are joining. Okay. Speak the truth. I can explain. But speak the truth. Okay. Objectives resolution. When the Constituent Assembly started the work of a drafting, you have already studied that for the making of the Constitution of India, a Constituent Assembly was formed, a Constituent Assembly was made. And when the Constituent Assembly started the work of drafting the Constitution of India, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru proposed objective resolutions that some such and such point should be included when the Constitution of India should be made. Objective resolutions on December 13, 1946. Okay. And he presented before the Assembly some points. The resolution highlighted the objectives and laid down the national goals. What was the goals? First, free India will be nothing but a republic. India became republic. Okay. On 26 January 1950. Okay. Sovereign democratic country it became when on 26 January 1950. The ideals of social, political and economic democracy would be guaranteed to all people. Okay, social freedom, social ideals of social ideals of political ideals, economic democracy would be guaranteed to all. Means all these things should be guaranteed to each and every citizen of the country. Third point, the republic would grant fundamental rights to citizens. Fundamental right. Okay, you studied in 8th class fundamental rights. Directive principles you also studied in 8th class. So fundamental rights, republic would grant fundamental rights to citizens. And the last point, the state would safeguard the rights of minorities. Means the rights of minorities, those who are minority in our country, their rights would be protected by the state. Okay, the state would safeguard the rights of minorities and backward passage. Okay, the objective, he presented before the Constituent Assembly that these objectives should be kept in mind while the drafting of the Constitution of India was made. Okay, and these objectives, okay, these objective resolution was passed by the Constituent Assembly on January 22nd, 1947. Okay. Okay. Now, next one. Next one. Okay. You have to keep in your mind all these points. Okay. And this fact file is given here. The Constituent Assembly, first important date, the Constituent Assembly elected July 1946. And the first session of the Constituent Assembly was held on December 9, 1946. Objectives resolution proposed. Just now I studied, proposed by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru on December 13, 1946, and it was passed on January 22, 1947. Drafting committee set up August 29, 1947. First draft completed February 1948. First reading November 1948, second reading October 1949, third reading November 1949, Constitution passed and adopted November 26, 1949, and effective on January 26, 1950. And 11th important date, the Constituent Assembly members, Undivided India. The Constituent Assembly members, Undivided India, 389, India by itself, 299. Muslim League, okay, I told you here, Muslim League, the Muslim League boycotted the Constituent Assembly to demand the creation for a separate state called Pakistan. Okay. Muslim League did not take part in the Constituent Assembly meeting. Okay. That's why Undivided India, 389 members, India by itself, 299. At the time of commencement, articles were 395 and schedules 8. These are the important dates you have to keep in your mind. And the first important thing, another important thing, see Rajgopalachari, became the Governor General of Independent India. He replaced Lord Mountbatten, the last British Governor General of India. Lord Mountbatten was the last British Governor General of India. And C. Rajagopalachari was the first and last first and last Indian Governor General of Independent India. First and last Governor General of Independent India was C. Rajagopalachari. And Lord Mountbatten was the last British Governor General of India. Okay. And the first meeting of the Constituent Assembly was presided over by Dr. Sachidanand Sinha, the oldest sitting member of the Central Assembly. Okay. And the meeting was held on December 9, 1946 in Central Hall in the Parliament of India. And on December 11, 1946, Dr. Rajan Prasad was elected President of the Constituent Assembly. Okay. So question and answer to this chapter. I think that you should try to write the answers yourself. Okay. I think that the answers are very easy.